In the previous video, we covered animation and the basics of the animation editor. Let's pick up from where we left off and track the keyed source over the background. The segment on the selected layer has an axis effect that is performing the key. If you want to track the image to the background, you can also do this using the same axis timeline effects. Go into the editor and right in the middle of the controls, you will see a button labeled Stabilizer. The Stabilizer is Smoke's 2D tracker, and the options beneath the Stabilizer are set up depending on the task. In this case, the Stabilizer is set to track with rotation and scale turned off. This means Smoke will only track position. Go to frame 1 and ensure you are using the layer transformations. You can click the Stabilizer button to enter into the tool. In the viewer, click and drag the center of the tracker boxes to position them over a part of the gladiator's uniform. If you've never used a tracker before, all you need to know is that the inner box is the region being tracked, and the outer box is the zone in which you predict the tracking region will move to in the coming frames. Pressing the Analyze button will start the track, and you can see the track path being created. There are plenty of controls to tweak more challenging tracks, however in this case, the track was straightforward. Press the Return button and you go back to the Axis menus, and the tracking data is applied to the surface object. You can see the animation in the X and Y position sliders if you were to scrub the time bar. The graphic has been centered over the tracking point that was used to analyze the background. To reposition the graphic to wherever you want, you need to change from the layer transformations to the offset transformations. You are basically working on another level of animation beneath the tracking data. I'll scale down the image object and reposition it to the right of the gladiator's face. Once the positioning is done, you can scrub the time bar to see how the tracking is working with the added position offset. Coming back out to the sequence, you can scrub the result as well as render it to have a final result. The next shot in the sequence is the opposing gladiator. This gladiator raises his sword, but there's a slight camera movement that I would like to eliminate. You can use the same tracking tools to do stabilization, but in a slightly different way. Select the segment and add an axis timeline effects using the effects ribbon. In the editor, you can change the settings beneath the stabilizer button. Just by changing the pull-down menu from track to stabilize, we'll apply the tracking data differently. Inside the stabilizer, go to frame 1, and click the center of the tracker boxes and position it on a point on the background. Press the Analyze button and let the software do the work. If you press Return to exit the tracker and scrub the time bar, you can see that the image is stabilized on the chosen point. All that is left to do is reposition the surface object to fit the frame so you don't get any of the black edges. You need to switch from the layer transformations to the offset transformations again. I'll scale the layer up slightly to fit the frame. You can scrub the time bar and see the effect. Exiting back to the sequence and rendering the result will give you your final output in the context of your edit. In the next video, you will have a look at the keying tools in the axis timeline effects and a workflow to pull a great key.